What's your favorite?
Oh, thank you. Thanks so much. I'll bring you a sandwich. You've got plenty of time.
I think a classic cocktail.
Okay.
Like
something on the lighter side.
Wait, do you have a cocktail? Do you have bubbles?
Yeah.
So how about, what is a French 70 cocktail? French 70 cocktail?
Yeah, certainly.
Wonderful. You're talking about a completely different project, nothing new. Well, I mean, it's his visual representation. And so I said, well, would it be helpful to play live? And I said, well,
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us for this live show. Before we get started with this wonderful group, I just want to let you know that this show and all shows done at Smalls are made possible through the Smalls Live Foundation and sponsored to that foundation. Tonight's show is sponsored by Exuberance Philadelphia. If you'd like to become a sponsor group here, you can reach out to us at foundation@smallslive.com if we tell you how to do that. Tonight we have the amazing Andrew Cyril on drums, Thomas Morgan on bass, and leading with one foot trio, which is Ethan Irison on piano.
Good evening. Good evening, and thanks for watching, or thanks for being here. At the sound check, it was a really pleasure to talk to Andrew Cyril. This is a kind of a Bud Powell release party. I just released the record with a quintet and a big band called Bud Powell in the 21st Century. However, a quintet and a big band is not really possible at the moment. I thought, well, I would really like to just play some Powell and maybe some Thelonious Monk with Andrew Cyril, who's the title of my record is Bud Powell in the 21st Century, and there's no one more 21st century than Andrew Cyril. But I was talking to Andrew, and it turns out one of the great Bud Powell records is Tom Waits, with Sam Jones and Philly Joe Jones. And it turns out Andrew was at that session because Philly Joe Jones was playing Andrew's drums. So we might play some of the music from that record in the second set. I have to sort of work up to that emotionally. But that's a great place to think about to start. And then on bass we have Thomas Morgan, who's a miracle. In fact, both Andrew and Thomas are miracles. Yes, please give them a hand. Thomas and Andrew. They're definitely the hippest rhythm section on the planet right now at 5 p.m. here in the Eastern Standard Time. And we're going to begin, I think, with a monk piece, try to warm into it, see what the spirits are going to let us play. This is Well You Mute.
Thank you.
You, it feels great to play. We'll continue with something by Bud Powell. Again, I'm honor bound by contractual agreement from all parties to announce this is the Bud Powell in 21st Century release party. It's this wonderful record right here and features Ingrid Jensen, Dana Stevens, Ben Street, Lewis Nash, and the Umbria Big Band. And on this record is what we're going to play right now, Bouncing with Bud.
Thank you.
one of Bud's tunes. He recorded this with Sonny Stitt. It's really nothing but more than four bars. It's called Bud's Blues. Thank you. behind you. That was, again, Bud's Blues. That's the truly extraordinary Andrew Cyril on drums. Thank you. And the magnificent Thomas Morgan on bass. We're going to continue with another Bud Powell bebop classic. This is Whale.
Thank you.
Cyril. Bud wrote some very beautiful ballads, some sort of through composed pieces. And this is his piece that's almost a standard, but you don't hear it that often, but Jackie McLean played it, Barry Harris plays it, a few Bud specialists know the song. It's I'll Keep Loving You.
Thank you.
This next Bud tune is something he played, but people almost think of it as a Bud tune, but it's actually by the great trumpet player Benny Harris. But I've played it a fair amount over the years, and frankly, I really wanted to play it with Andrew Cyril. So here it is, Reets and I.
Thank you.
a great time playing for you. I think we'll do one more. Yeah, it's really, it is really nice to play for a few people too. It's really, that's a lot of fun. I remember a few, let me just monologue for a second.
Yes.
First time I saw Andrew Surreal, it was at an outdoor concert at Bryant Park. He was playing trio with Oliver Lake and Reggie Workman.
Oh.
Sometimes known as Trio 3, and it was maybe 92, 93, something like that. And I sat in my chair and I thought, this is the greatest jazz I've ever heard in my life, was the set. I was hip to all three of them. I had already been collecting the records and stuff, and then I was like, man, you hear these three people playing together in the air right now, really something else. I saw Andrew with one of my all-time heroes, Mal Waldman, at the Village Vanguard with Reggie Workman. That was another memorable experience. And I've seen Andrew a lot with my friend Bill McHenry. And that's when the first time I realized maybe I'll get to play with Andrew someday if like Bill's playing with him. It's like, Bill's my friend, so maybe I'll get to. And then I actually got to sub for Orrin Evans and play with Andrew. We played a couple of freer pieces, and I thought, this is the highest level. And I spoke to Andrew afterwards, and I said, well, it just feels so good. It just feels so swinging, but we're not really playing time. It's a sort of a different expression. He said, well, you just cook the vegetables on the stove, like just, you know, keep them there cooking. I thought, exactly. Then I played a little bit with Andrew on my own, and I especially enjoyed hearing him recently with Ben Street, playing with Joe Lovano, playing with a few other people. One of the best streams I saw from the past year was with Joe Lovano, Ben Street, and Andrew. And, it's just, anytime you can get out and see the real deal, like Andrew Surreal, you should. You know, so thanks again to Andrew Surreal for being here tonight. Sort of played with both Bud and Monk, sort of. You'll have to get him for the details. It wasn't really a proper gig, but he did a jam session with Bud and sort of was on the stage with Monk at one point. That's how close we are to the real glory era of this music. We can still come down to Smalls and see them play. On bass is Thomas Morgan, our hero. Thomas is, of course, one of the avant-garde masters, but I am doing what I can in my own little way to show that he's one of the great swinging bass players of all time, sort of a personal project of mine. And of course, he's just incredible tonight as well. So thank you, Thomas Morgan, for being here.
Yeah.
Somewhere, Kenny Clark says that Thelonious Monk wrote for Bud Powell, like an opera singer, writes for his star soprano. And that's at least true to the extent that Bud Powell recorded off minor before Monk did. And there's a Monk tune that Monk never recorded, but Bud played his whole life. And we'll finish this set with that tune. It's a 52nd Street theme. I'm Ethan Iverson, the record is Bud Powell in the 21st Century, and thank you for listening. This one is too fast. Thank you.
Ethan Anderson, Andrew Sorrell, Thomas Morgan. Thank you so much to the amazing musicians, and thank you so much to the sponsor. Thank you to all of you who are here tonight. There's a next set at 7 p.m. Those who are watching online, those who are here in person. And thanks so much. Once again, Ethan Anderson.
Thank you. Bye. really drunk, this guy's really drunk.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us for this show at Smalls. Before we get started with this band, I just want to let you know that this show and all shows done at Smalls are made possible through the Smalls Live Foundation and sponsored through the foundation. Tonight's show is sponsored by Exuberance Philadelphia. Tonight we are honored to have Mr. Andrew Surreal on the drums, Thomas Morgan on bass, and leading this wonderful trio, Mr. Ethan Iverson on piano.
Thank you so much for being here, a few of you in the club, and also hello to everybody watching online. This is a kind of record release party. In January, an album came out featuring a quintet and a big band of my arrangements of Bud Powell music. And of course, it's not the time to bring in a big band anywhere, at least not the Smalls. So, the record is called Bud Powell in the 21st Century. And,
Great album.
The most 21st century musician I know is Andrew Surreal. So I thought, well, let's invite Mr. Surreal to join me and Thomas Morgan to go through some of this repertoire. I have to say this again, that as we're setting up, there's a great Bud Powell album, Time Waits, with Sam Jones and Philly Joe Jones, and turns out Andrew was at that session because Philly Joe Jones was using Andrew Surreal's drums that day.
Wow.
That just shows you how recent this music really is. We're also going to play some Monk tunes because they were close, and it just seemed the right thing to do. So actually, we're going to start with a Monk tune, one of my favorites, called Crisscross.
Thank you.
We're going to play one of Bud's tunes now. This is Dance of the Infidels.
Thank you.
Monk again and his famous composition, Misterioso.
Thank you.
and play Baya. Andrew Cyril didn't play with Monk quite. He shared the bandstand a little bit. I'll have to get him to explain it. And he also sort of sat in with Bud Powell one time. So it's pretty incredible to be playing with a musician here in 2021 who knew these people that I've been studying my whole life. Of course, I've been studying Andrew my whole life, too. But it's also just such a blast to play. Thank you for being here. We're having such a good time playing. Record Bud Powell in the 21st Century. There's a quintet with Dana Stevens, Ingrid Jensen, Ben Street, and Lewis Nash, and the whole Umbria Jazz Big Band. Due to circumstances beyond my control, I was not able to assemble all those musicians at Smalls tonight, but we're playing some of Bud's music and some of Monk's music. One of the feature tracks on the record is one of his legendary ballads by Bud Powell. This is "I'll Keep Loving You."
Thank you.
Time to play Bud's song Celia, written for his daughter. I was doing an event with some great pianists in Durham, and there was someone I didn't know before the gig, Ernest Turner, and it turned out his math teacher, when he was in fifth grade, was Celia Powell. I'll never forget that moment talking to him. He's like, oh yeah, I knew Celia. Celia Powell?
Thank you.
time playing for you all, and appreciate you coming out to see us, taking a chance, and we certainly appreciate all of you watching out there. It means a lot to play a gig. It means a lot for me to play with the great Andrew Cyril, who I've been loving all of his playing on so many records for so many years. And I've seen him play a lot, a fair amount in New York, and it's great when you play with a legend, they're even better than you think. It's quite consistent. I've managed to play with a few legends now, here and there, and it's always like, yeah, it's even better. So please, thank you, Andrew. Please give it up for Andrew Cyril. Some people think the bass is a non-melodic instrument. But there's one person who plays the most goddamn extraordinary melodies on the acoustic bass, and that is Mr. Thomas Morgan. We're going to finish up with a piece by Monk, but perhaps written for Bud. It's on record somewhere that Kenny Clarke said that Thelonious Monk wrote for Bud Powell the way a, you know, Italian opera singer wrote for his star soprano. And there are a few things that Bud played that he must have gotten straight from Monk. He played off minor before Monk recorded it, and he played nice work, if you can get it, sort of in a way that Monk played it. But then there's one song of Monk's that Monk never recorded, and Bud played his whole life. And we'll finish the set with that. It's 52nd Street Theme. Again, Andrew Cyril, Thomas Morgan, Ethan Iverson, have a great night. Bud Powell in the 21st century. Thank you.
Ethan Aberson, the amazing Andrew Sarone, Thomas Morgan. Thank you so much to Zulu and Philadelphia for sponsoring the show. Thank you so much for all of you who are here to witness this and to take part in live music. Once again, the great Ethan Aberson. Next up, we have Miki Yamanaka with her group. If you want to stick around for that, you're more than welcome to. Thanks so much. Have a great night.